much, Radostina, for the wonderful introduction. And thank you, distinguished audience, for being here today for my presentation. Now that you talked about me and reminded me about what I did recently, I just realized that actually I just mastered the art of establishing a sustainable cross-cultural social capital as a PhD student in front of you. Initially, when I started this presentation, I was very theoretical about it, and because I'm into this research mood right now, and I was going through the definitions of establishing sustainable cross-cultural social capital, and going one more, what is social capital, what is culture, and all this. And then I read this very beautiful motivational note that says that, and it's in line with the name of our conference today, the title of the conference, that whatever we are trying to achieve in our life, whatever hobby, professional, and piece of art that we want to create, is actually doing one thing and only. It's taking us one step ahead of mastering the most important piece of art that we are going to create in our lives, and that is ourselves. So in that view, I said, why don't I talk about how I'm at this stage of artfulness in my life, where after I worked, that was my recent experience, to be a counselor for the Minister of International Society of Romania. I have my own company as an event planner. I have various institutions in at least, active institutions, at least four NGOs, Hope and Homes for Children of Romania, Teach for Romania, Touch Romania, SOS Children Romania, and all this activities and my institution got me to really master, you know, I can say, definitely, the thing of cultural social capital. My PhD, and that got me even with my idea to have my PhD supported and sponsored by one of my partners, for example. When we talk about capital social, social capital, we talk about, also we think about the intellectual one, the creative capital. They're all puzzles that make us who we are. My research, this topic is related with my research, it's in diplomacy legacy. And legacy viewed as a continuous act to one's career rather than a result after the fact. So it is at the early ages when we decide the way that we want to go towards, we see the goals. Obviously, we gather more and more, let's say, experience, we refine our decisions, but definitely, that all the steps that we do, they take us closer to our initial goal. I will give you a broad perspective of the concept of social capital and some topics related to it. But once I will do that, I will talk about social capital as a direct implication in clubs, and how that can drive your network, and from one knot of experience, you know how you can get multiple connections that can help you to be closer to your own career and personal goals. So as you see, and now talking to the piece of art that any career person, any diplomat is considering,
has into we can should take into consideration being a volunteer. That should not be confused. Usually, it's confused with being philanthropic. And volunteer is related to cultural. You can relate it to corporate social responsibility, for example. But when you say philanthropic, you talk about a rich person giving an amount of its surplus towards a certain goal that is a personal goal rather. So when you talk volunteer about being a volunteer and broadening your social capital by being a volunteer, you talk about being actively involved in community in corporate social responsibility. That obviously is achieved through solidarity, bridging, bonding, and I'm going to talk further once I will do this introduction about the different clubs and the difference in what we are looking for when we join a club. Because sometimes we are looking for to bond with people, and then we go to a certain type of clubs, and then most of the times in the let's say there are various associations and clubs where that's foster rather bridging between people. We'll come back to this slide, as I would like to talk to you, and I would like to go through just underlining a few options that ones have to network and to gather their capital. And I will start with something rather intriguing and secretive, because the Masonic and the Freemasonry has oftentimes and is oftentimes perceived as a secretive association, not association, a community rather, because they're not an association, they're a community and they're a club. And I will give you a few facts about it. As the Freemasonry is a fraternal organization, and it traces its origins to the local fraternities of stonemasons, which from the end of the 14th century regulated the qualifications of stonemasons and their interaction with authorities and clients. The basic local organizational unit of Freemasonry is a lodge. The lodges are usually supervised and governed at the regional level by a Grand Lodge or Grand Orient. The most commonly shared rules for recognition are those given by United Grand Lodge of England in 1929, because the Freemasons, they divide quite a few in independent lodges, and they do not necessarily recognize each other as being legitimate. Some of the shared rules are a belief in a supreme being and the scripture is a condition membership. Initiates should take their vows on the scripture. Only men can be admitted, and no relationship exists and with mixed lodges. The Grand Lodge has complete control over the first three degrees and is not subject to another body. And there is no discussion of politics or religious, so they say. So basically, let's say something is that times one would oftentimes inquire, but it's not something impossible to get into. Usually you have to be normally you have to be recommended by a member and to go through certain stages of being accepted. So one of the clubs. A more, let's say, approachable clubs for many from our perspective would be, for example, the Lions Clubs. There are Lion Clubs for women, Lion Clubs for men. They don't mix. They're just like the another, I would say, similar club, the Rotary Club. They have over 1 million over 1 million members. I'm talking about the Lions, they have 1,200,000 and the Rotary 1,400,000 right now. And they are rather focused on the communities, local communities, but they are led by international by international head. So how do they work? Members are people from business, arts, academic community, and not only. They work to solve their community challenges. Their efforts are supported by the international organization, member associations, and the foundations, which turn to donate grants that fund the work of members and partners around the world. They are led by members who help to carry forward the organization mission and values in their elected roles. The differences between Lions and Rotary would be that the Rotary Club is rather a networking club, and the Lions Club is rather a charity-oriented, community-changing club. But for the reasons of networking, one would rather go to the Rotary Club. These clubs, I do consultancy for my strategic communication for my clients, and what I usually do for them is not necessarily go into the details of the class they belong to, but I help them manage their reputation within the club. Because if one would join any type of group and is not active, there is no result. There is no result going to happen at the end. So, based on our reputation on trust and as a continuity, obviously we have to be active and to take it to the for the level. Between, let's say, Freemasons and the other two clubs that I mentioned, they are I would say that they are similar in that they all do good for the community. But the Freemasonry is the oldest fraternity and allows only men. It also teaches a system for morality that the others do not. They are committed to helping each other in times of distress and working together to better relationship in community. So rather, Freemasonry is a fraternity which differentiates from the others. But now that I give you an introduction and a short brief about this club that I would call them bridging clubs, and by bridging, I mean that they provide access, resources, innovation, and they have quite an impact on one's career. I would go to the other type of organizations, which are more social, and they rather help us bond. And that is based on affinity, belonging, trust, support, and community. It is one association that helped me a lot to understand the community needs, and it's a women's club, but I would rather turn out to the international women's club. They exist in each country. When I returned after many years spent in the United States, California, I returned back to Romania, and I wouldn't necessarily find myself, let's say, at home. I wasn't an American citizen. Initially, I went to the embassy and I said, okay, let's, they should take note that I'm here. And I found, like, okay, thank you. They picked the passport that I'm there. But I was really looking forward to, of course, I didn't visit for many years before I came back to Romania. So I was how do you call it, a hybrid, you know? I didn't find my own identity in my own country, which was quite a distress at that time. So my instinct, and it so happened that I joined this international ladies club, the international ladies club, I will talk simply about them in generally. Because there are different type of clubs that unite until different umbrellas, but mainly they are non-political, non-religious, non-commercial. The members are open to women of all nationalities. The percentage of one nationality cannot exceed usually about 20-25% of the total membership, And the size of each group varies from a few individuals to more than 600, depending obviously on the size of the city, of the of the country, or of the international situation in that particular time. For example, when Romania just joined the European Union, obviously there were quite a few job opening positions for expats to come to Romania. So that really enhanced the association, and they became like something like 200 members, and they're all spouses of diplomats and expats in Romania. As I said, the members are diplomatic affiliated, academic, homemakers, businesswomen relocated because of temporary job postings, that would be my case, or for their own spouse's work, and that would be the majority of the cases. The working language is in English, and usually such an association has a very diverse board. You can see here from the from your right to your left, the board aligned in the, and visiting and greeting the audience for one of the main events, and you see a Romanian, Azerbaijan, from Syria, Azerbaijan again, from Pakistan, Russia, United States, Germany, Turkey, USA, me as a Romanian American, and an Italian, the spouse of the Italian ambassador at that time in Bucharest. So that would be a board of such a group, with a diverse background, all of them, of course, but united for the same mission: to promote friendship, to provide opportunities for social and cultural exchange between women of all nationalities under the spirit of mutual understanding, and foster a better understanding of local culture and society. Second, and for me very important mission is philanthropic and charitable, to assist selected charity groups and to encourage members to enhance in goodwill activities. Most of the time, the aid is directed towards local communities. I wrote philanthropic because this is rather a grant type of, they are grant type of association, and they redirect the funds collected towards certain associations that are active for a certain goal. So these are, they create the, gather the funds for from the international community in one city, and then find usually a local community where they direct those funds. They have activities, usually there is a monthly meeting where all the group unites, communicating all the details through newsletter and print and online. Yeah, or the and the activities are diverse. The beauty of such a social club and the effect that is so unique is that the members create the activities, and they organize them, they promote them, and they're all free for the members. So usually there is a fee that is no more than, I'd say, 50 euros per year, the moderate fee, and the rest of activities should be free. This is in the statute of most associations. So from outings, the regular visits to art museums and exhibitions, cocktail parties with partners, cooking classes, cultures, coffees and lunches, sports, bridge, conversation groups, in the mostly they have English, German, French and Spanish, trying to understand the local language, and that's always useful. But I would say that from what I observed, the most popular one is the cooking classes, where everybody gathers around, very curious under one nationality's gourmet and experience in cuisine. Also, I had the privilege to meet lovely ladies that decided that upon such experience in one country to write a book. So everybody provides their own, they, what I say now is they create their own legacy, right? I mean, to live in a country for 2 years, to write a book about it, then you obviously have a goal in mind, you're closer to your active legacy. This is the case of a lady that I admire very much. She lives in Berlin. I met her when I came to Berlin a month ago, and I looked for such jobs, and I enrolled in the American Ladies Report for Berlin. And the head of the club is from Berlin, France, that wrote this Beyond Borders book, that is a collection of stories, photographic stories, that she collected while her she lived in several countries. Then my dear friend Jane Golden's book, actually she's not Jane, she just published her book under the name of Jane, she's Patty Golden, she was the president of that institution 2 years ago in Bucharest. I was her first vice president. And she had quite a tough time understanding the culture of Bucharest and the culture of the 20% of the Romanian ladies that were members of that the association. So her approach was not as artistic, but rather she wrote this story. It was a police, it was a crime type of story. I guess the fact that her husband was in Bucharest until a criminal justice topic is linked as well, but nevertheless quite an interesting one. And I think about bonding and cross-cultural exchange, Patty is launching her book in North Carolina now. I had the privilege to present the book as I'm one of the main characters of it, and this was my gift for my 40th birthday this year. So absolutely bonding we are talking here about. So I mentioned some of the activities. Usually, most of the time there is a large fundraising event. The goal of each association is to unite as many countries of the that are under the umbrella of the association and create this bazaar. It can be a Christmas bazaar, a spring bazaar. I was in Romania. There was this Christmas bazaar happening, I think for the audience, for you to understand the type of let's say cultural cross-cultural understanding existing under such umbrella, we debated at one point this event should be called a Christmas bazaar or a winter bazaar, just because of the connotation of Christmas and religion acceptance. And I was absolutely, and I still have goosebumps, as it was unanimously, almost voted to be a Christmas bazaar. And I was the first vice president at that time. I took several positions in the board. Now I'm just the nomination committee. I'm creating the board. And I asked, but why? And the general acceptance was, but we are in Romania, and this is an Orthodox country, and we should pay respect for Romania, and this is the country that we chose to live in. This is our home now. And this is what we are talking about. I will start, and I have a few examples. I will leave the language as it is, as part of your cross-cultural experience. And I will start with such an event. I will point out to two similar bazaars because I would like for you to see the how close they are to each other, even though happening in different countries. And I'll start with the Czech one.
Centru za odgoj i obrazovanje iz Karlovca. Supruge veleposlanika i drugih stranih državljana u Hrvatskoj zasukale su rukave, iskuhale hranu i ispekle kolače, tipične za zemlju iz koje dolaze. Većina je vrlo brzo planula, a delicijama nije odoljela ni prva dana.
This is pumpkin pie.
Od tipične američke pite od bundeve i kanadskih palačinki s javorovim sirupom, pa do egzotičnih jela poput indijske i iranske hrane.
Hranu su napravile žene iz veleposlanstva. Naša je hrana najbolja. Sve je nestalo za samo 2 sata. Ostali su samo kolači.
Pivo smo imali samo 30 minuta.
Pitjame špinat, remedijas.
Na 20. humanitarnom sajmu na Zagrebačkom velesajmu stranci u Hrvatskoj pripremili su hranu, rukotvorine i ostale domaće proizvode iz čak 34 zemlje.
Naša keramika iz Modre, ona ima 500-godišnju tradiciju.
Prodajemo kolačiće od džumbira, domaće, ali i one iz Ikea. Imamo i domaće kekse od šafrana.
Njih je kupila supruga predsjednika Republike Tatjana Josipović, koja je otvorila humanitarni božićni sajam, no vino koje prija uz kekse nije htjela. Pa je zavirila u novčanik i na slovačkom štandu.
To su tipični opće sirevi, to su gove pari.
Meni je drago da mogu biti dio te akcije, evo već treću ili četvrtu godinu. Kao što vidite, ima jako puno posjetitelja, svako daje neki svoj prilog.
Prikupljeni novac organizatorice sajma svake godine doniraju drugoj udruzi.
Nadamo se da mi ćemo skupiti 200.000 kuna za Centar za odgoj i obrazovanje za mladeže i djecu u Karlovcu.
Da se tom iznosu mogu nadati, potvrđuje i gužva.
Sviđa nam se izvor hrane, nam je super i raznolikost.
Svake godine ovo super događa, cijeli svijet na jednom mjestu.
Cijeli svijet koji vlastitim trudom pomaže drugima u nevolji.
In Croatia, sorry. I wrote this long on that. I will show you the...
De la bijuterii la kebab și de la parfumuri la whisky irlandez, bazarul de Crăciun, pregătit la București pe 2 decembrie de Organizația Internațională a Femeilor, oferă vizitatorilor nenumărate soluții la dificila întrebare ce cadou să cumpăr de Crăciun. Acest lucru pare să-l fi descoperit și publicul din România. Cu mic cu mare, 2000 de persoane au vizitat anul trecut bazarul, iar încasările au atins 300.000 de lei și toată suma a fost donată către organizații caritabile, dar nu totul se învârte în jurul banilor.
Din punctul nostru de vedere, rezultatele sunt cele de suflet, cele mai importante, pentru că aș dori ca despre ele să vorbim, mai puțin despre cele financiare, care într-adevăr au fost importante și care ne-au ajutat să ajutăm cel puțin 15 asociații din București și proximitate în ultimul an. Ne referim aici la, cămine de bătrâni, la mame aflate în dificultate, la copii, la oameni nevoiași.
Duminică este așteptată participarea a peste 30 de țări la bazarul ce va avea loc în incinta Romexpo. Este probabil că numărul participanților din acest an va fi cel mai mare din cei 22 de ani de când se organizează bazarul. Organizatorii sunt în mare parte soțiile diplomaților străini acreditați la București, dar și femei care aparțin comunității civile, respectiv de comunități de afaceri și culturale. Și toți sunt foarte atenți ca programul să fie variat, nu doar un simplu bazar cu tarabe.
We are going to sell some traditional Korean food. Already prepared ourselves, and also Korean embassy, we are preparing some musical performance. The children, 14 children will dance on the stage, the Korean pop song, Gangnam style, and also 4 Korean small children, they will show our own traditional costume.
Acest fel de inițiative caritabile contribuie poate mai mult decât orice acțiune diplomatică la contactul direct între națiuni, iar satisfacția este cel puțin la fel de intensă pentru organizatori cât pentru beneficiarii donațiilor.
You know, it's very important for us this Christmas bazaar. For me, I feel it's it's a good place to show your country. And it's, although it's good to give hands and help to the needers peoples all over the world, which increase the civilization between the peoples and which increase the sense of the duty to help others and to give hands, whether despite the religions, the place, the country. So you feel that it's a good for us to show that we are useful in this life.
Bazarul de Crăciun se deschide duminică 2 decembrie de la ora 10 și toată lumea este așteptată.
So just give you two examples, the Croatian one and the Romanian bazaar, but obviously, as I was telling you, they vary in size. But rather I would like you to think of it as an opportunity and to encourage you to join such clubs. And if you join, not to be just a member, to have a strategy, just like anything we do in life, it requires a direction and a strategy. Just become becoming a member of any of these institutions do not give you any step ahead of your act. So I would advise you not to join if you do not decide not to do get involved, and the implications and the impact in one's career and personal life, let's say in personal life a little bit less sometimes because of the volunteering time, because it's all volunteer work, of course. The personal implications, let's say, are rather important from the personal view, but professional, definitely, they drive me one step ahead in my career. And I'll give you an example of how this can help in career. Obviously, for all these events, I brought this, I was very happy that it matched the topic of today with culinary innovation. Through such events, for such event, I brought a personal contact of mine, because obviously, and especially as a leader for the event, I was very determined to make sure that it's the most successful, that I have more countries than I had the year before. We achieved, for this particular one, we had 41 countries represented, 18 ambassadors selling with their stand. The president's wife, spouse, visited the bazaar, and they raised 50,000 euros in one day of sale from 10 to 4 o'clock. And the budget that my team had was 2,500 euros to organize it. So obviously we had to tap into all the possible resources to plant a little seed. I'll give you the example of Laboratoarele Remedia Green Sugar. It's a sweetener made of stevia. They decided to participate, but not only to participate because they all these companies, they would go through my hand first. And I said, okay, I do not accept that you just give us boxes of green sugar and put it in our container. We don't even have quite a space to store it. You have to be involved, you have to be active. And the way they decided to be active was to create bake goods, international cross-cultural goods for each stand. And they had stevia, which has zero calories, zero glycemic in these natural herbal regions. It's decorative for diabetes, so quite an amazing product. Plus that it was discovered, I went and researched a little bit, it was discovered in Paraguay, and it's been used in Japan for many years, who would have known. It was a product created in Romania, and it was present in almost every single stand that bazaar. So with that in mind, I would rather encourage you, I don't know, to ask me if you have any questions. As a conclusion, I would rather take questions from you. Thank you so much for it.
Thank you very much, Marina. this is really great job, and I believe that this type of international really give us chance to contribute something. The activists really give us a lot of chances to contribute our future, of course, to our better life. Okay, please.
Thank you for the presentation. I just wanted to know your thoughts on, sometimes there can be kind of a concept of some of the social groups being somewhat elitist, like not open to everyone. So I wanted to get your thoughts on how you feel about volunteering and giving back. Sometimes can be seen in those groups more so as to network for your own advancement or kind of for publicity versus really giving back. Just for the love of giving back to your community or your society. So just wanted to get your thoughts on that.
So from what you told me, then I will start with, let's say, you're coaching you personally, because, because obviously you have your goals. Through everything that is through your question, you already answered what type of association is good for you. So maybe not a social one, you're not going to relate to necessarily, but maybe a topic that would be on your heart, being human rights, women rights, children rights, nature, or something that is part of your life. You can definitely be active in the community. You can find the corporate social responsibility association. The social clubs, rather, if you are not particularly interested in networking, I would say that they need you. Sometimes we undervalue, I find, and I'm talking about me personally here, the contribution that my unique experience and personality can bring to such association. And especially for those that do not fit in, I would definitely recommend to join, but that would be a challenge if you want to accept that. One of the debates that one can have after the dissertation. If you have your requirements met, you are part of that group. So it's rather maybe sometimes a stereotype that is elitist. You can be part of that elitist group for any time. And in Romania, for the 20%, for example, the ladies who are Romanian, I told them I think the difference is with the American and the 20% that are doing, you know, that they are from such diverse backgrounds, and it doesn't have to be necessarily that they are spouses of ambassadors or diplomats in general or businessmen. You know, you have, indeed, I was the only working with a woman in that board, but it's my unique contribution to the board, into the situation. So do not undervalue your, your contribution, but rather, you can, yeah.
My question is connected to the previous question. I myself, I'm in Rotaract for 10 years.
Rotaract
is, Rotaract for younger people under 30. And I was the founder of my local Rotaract. But then I had the same issue of her actually. But I had issue to attract young people. Because of these stereotypes, nobody wanted to get in. Everybody was like, no, it's not for me, it's such an artistic thing. No, it's for rich people. I don't know. I was like, no, this is for young people who want to do something. And for me, Rotaract, it gave me really a lot. I was traveling with it then. But it's not just that. I think that we were doing lots of voluntary things, not just networking. I would correct you that we were on the garbage, honestly. At one moment we were cleaning the
project. No, when I said the networking, I was making the differentiating between Lions and Rotaract.
From club to club, from the community. But obviously the fact that you were the dynamic and the young side of the group, definitely you are active, you are going to the ground with
So my question is, from the point of people who are active, what are trying to attract, that you are involved, how to attract people, how to break the stereotypes. And my other question is, I didn't have lots of information, but do you also like face these stereotypes? It's like a little bit sexist, because now we are seeing all these ambassadors, like women in general, who are cooking, and there is like a vice president who is also like cooking, and there's a Czech ambassador who is selling beer.
We sexist? You know,
like you mean like a okay. bit of like.
I want to make sure that I answer correctly. I was part of the, not political. I talk about my piece as a leader of such an association. I was the youngest in the board when I joined first 5 years ago. I had to be consistent in my approach, because here I come with my extensive, and this is what actually pushed me and kept me, you know, my passion for emotional intelligence, and I'm an event planner. So they needed my resources. I knew they needed my resources, and I saw this as a nice platform, and I loved this event. So it was important for me personally to be there. And nevertheless, I by consistency, I gained my respect and appreciation and respect from the beginning, obviously, but then the respect for my work, which was rather stereotyped in the beginning, and I would agree with you that this is how I felt as well. But look at me talking from the point of leading the situation for projects, because that was a tension to that we couldn't have done for my day. And I did not expect to have a time for that. Language, that was my recommendation, so I did not accept it. But indeed, we have it, and I am believe in community, and my life perspective definitely is not a feminist side. So I don't know how it was. And the book that I built is a matter. This is a matter of it's a personal matter of perception.
In my knowledge, there is a lot of different type of initiatives which this international women group here. I mean, it's not related only with women. Definitely very active, for example, in cooperation with UNESCO and some kind of different international organizations.
That is a professional association. This is a social club. We are talking here about bonding, friendship, opening doors. I've never been to any of my colleagues in my open house or children's association. I've never visited one of my colleagues in almost every single day with good dining, sharing dining experiences with them, life stories, helping them to adjust to the media.
Thank you very much for the very interesting and different presentation, and for sharing your experience with us. I would like to know more about how these clubs can work also as a very active platform, maybe connecting with the cultural scene and the artistic scene of the places that they are. I mean, you showed us a lot of good examples of the charity work and the social responsibility, but I'm sure that you might have some examples or experience in dealing with?
Now that you ask, I skipped it because I thought it was too long, but I even have a field that I can now present, and I will tell you a story for the event. In the group was absolutely phenomenal. They flew from their digital district, they flew from Palestine a group of dancers that danced for this event. I will give you an answer to the question. Of the ambassador and the group actually, the country decided to put the picture of their leader on the pillar that happened to be behind the stand. It was quite a difficult for friction and the leaders were stretched, the cameras. I will show you that in the field where the staff of the president. You'll see that I was between the staff of the president and the honorary president of the staff of the Austrian ambassador. And behind me there was a pillar where that picture was. And all the cameras were filming that this is the staff of the president, and they would have captured definitely the picture of the leader as well. And after a few discussions that didn't work anyway, I'm not going into the details, I approached the somebody in charge there, and through my I exposed my case in 1 minute. I remember that she looked into my eyes for another 1 minute, and she said, I know you, and I will do this for you. And she took it off. So this is bonding. And we are talking international, transnational things, and to be honest, I was extremely, extremely stressed at that moment. We had to Israel, USA, everybody was featured, they were all the ambassadors were there, somebody thought, started to pick their, so it was quite a situation, and I was always thinking, oh my God, war started from less than this, that was always in my head, but the level of bonding that I created, so I worked with this woman, just like you said that you worked in Rotary, from the ground, so we bonded through working together. And this is how you achieve your, so it has to be consistent and it develops over time. It cannot just happen. And now the movie, which is actually a beautiful intercultural art experience, and that is your fun. Anyway, no, but it's more. Okay. It was